Greetings, AMC viewers. Welcome to Script to Screen. My name is John Campia, and today I am very excited to be joined by the director of the newest Twilight film, the Twilight Saga Eclipse, which opens in AMC theaters everywhere on June 30th. I'm joined by Mr. David Slade. David, how you doing? Thanks for joining us.
I'm all right. I'm a little nervous. I think, T-minus 24 hours now to the premiere, but I'm good.
Exciting times. Now, listen, I should make an observation here before I ask you your first question. And that is that there is something of a mystical element to your films, because my lady and I, our very first date involved watching the DVD of 30 Days of Night. And last week we got married. So to all you ladies out there who are looking to lock down a guy, I highly recommend getting them out to see a David Slade film, particularly on the 30th to see the Twilight Saga Eclipse. David, when a franchise like Twilight has multiple directors, and we've seen several of them, each director kind of brings a unique stamp, a unique mark to that particular film that they work on. When you first considered working on Twilight Saga Eclipse, what sort of stamp were you hoping to bring to it that was distinctly yours?
This was an epic story, and it kind of drew upon all of the skills that I had. It was an epic story in the sense of it was the conclusion of a three-arc character story. And without giving too much away, it involved the lead character going down a very, very kind of huge journey and transforming. You know, it was a real Joseph Campbell-type journey, you know. Mm. And then at the end, she transforms. And in not literally, but just emotionally in terms of a character. And then we had these other far-reaching in terms of time stories, which were all concurrent about people's origins. And, you know, it just seemed to be an expansive thing. So to me, you know, we started out, we were going to shoot anamorphic, but we couldn't do that because of certain restrictions. So I just went for a really cinematic, and when I say cinematic, I mean, you know, in a very traditional classical sense, look to this, and then developed my own personal vocabulary around that idea, if that makes any sense at all. I don't know.
Now, by looking at the trailers for Eclipse, one gets mm-hmm. the sense at this point that there is more of an emphasis on action, and we know that there's war in this story. How much more prevalent is the action element in this film as compared to the other two Twilight films?
Well, I think there is more action in this film, which comes from the story. I mean, the thing is, Eclipse of the books is kind of one of the more dynamic of Stephanie's stories, in the sense of, you know, there's so much going on. In fact, you know, one of the toughest jobs I would say that we had, generally speaking, as a production, was, you know, between Melissa Rosenberg and I getting the damn thing into a screenplay, you know, that was satisfying and hit all of the points of the book. Because the book's like, where is it? Right in front of me. It's like, I'd like to get, you know, I'm actually going to get a ruler here. I'm going to measure the book. You know, so the pages of the hardback that I have in front of me are, it's a two inches of not particularly well-spaced, not particularly largely spaced text. So getting that into a screenplay, which is, and I have one of those, but not exactly a one, which is only 3/4 of an inch, just being technical there for a second, was one of the toughest parts, really, you know, about getting everything in. But the story just has those big episodes in it, you know. There was one instance in which I felt like, you know, if we don't bring something forward, everything's going to happen in the third act. And so there's a part of the book where there's a part of the book where a certain particular piece of action takes place, but we only get to know about it through a note that's passed across the table. And I was like, we got to see that. Mm. You know, we're going to be objective. We're not, as the book is, entirely from Bella's point of view. So we must see that. Let's do that. Let's actually make that an action set piece, which is one of the earliest ones. And it was a great one for me because it was the challenge of doing all the things vampires do really early on in the movie and just really establishing that really quickly as, well, you know, we've had another look at this. and we're going to make it much more realistic looking and really try and make you believe this. So that was a chase sequence. It's quite early in the film. There's loads more. We had like 6 decapitations, I think.
Now, last question.
I don't know what that exact number.
The last question I have for you here is, when you're working in a very unique situation here where you're working on a middle chapter of a larger story arc, did you, as a filmmaker, did you find it limiting or liberating knowing that you had to complete this film in such a way that it handed it off well for the next film to come along? How challenging was that for you?
This is a fairly unique situation because it's, even though there is a fourth book, it's not really a middle section. It's actually a conclusion of sorts because it concludes the storyline that begins in Twilight, pushes through New Moon, kind of concludes in this, and the fourth book is what happens afterwards. Other than that, this was actually the conclusion. It's the conclusion, really, of the love triangle in many ways, and it's the conclusion of Bella's choice. So, actually, I didn't really have to deal with that element of it. That wasn't challenging at all. It really was, you know, for me, this is the end, you know.
Right.
And it's like the you know, and so all of the themes led to a conclusion. So it was actually very, very satisfying, and that wasn't an issue that I had to deal with at all. You know, if you're meaning going back to taking that question backwards and projecting it to the previous films, I was, you know, I had to be completely respectful of the lore and the mythology and the stories. And some of the things that it were idiosyncratic to the film, but not necessarily to the books,
right.
Just to keep continuity. But visually, you know, I was encouraged just to make it as strong and as idiosyncratic as I wanted to, which is what I did.
Well, David, congratulations on the film. I know many of us were very intrigued and excited when we heard that you were attached to it. Good luck, and we look forward to June the 30th.